many, many verses as we are going to follow a story. Actually, just by reading the verses, will already give us the story of what we're going to study today. So you have to bear with me. And Milka, please be ready because I believe we are going to read an equivalent of 4 chapters today as we study the Word of God. So talk to the evil spirits that are trying to pull your eyelids, the windows of your eyes to close. And do something about it, because this is, I believe, is a very interesting study if you love the Word of God, but it is quite boring if you do not really desire to know God's Word. So that is already a rebuke and a reminder that you will not sleep as we go through our study this morning. Shall we stand up and pray before we read our text? Father, we thank you for the opportunity that you have given us that we can once again study your word. I pray, Lord, that you will give us an understanding mind. You will give us a tender heart so that, Lord, the truths and the principle and the doctrines that we will study today will be absorbed and applied, Lord, in our lives. I pray that you will give me wisdom because I have not known God by myself, but with the help of the Holy Spirit, Lord, this study can be a blessing, Lord, to your people. I pray that you and you alone will be glorified in our midst. And I pray, O God, that we will continue to see your hands as you move, Lord, in our lives. Deal with us, O God. Give us our needs spiritually. And make us, Lord, a better Christian than before as we study these things. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. You may be seated. Let us open our Bible in 2 Kings chapter 23. 2 Kings chapter 23. And we will read from verse number 21 to 25. 2 Kings chapter 23:21-25. Okay, so I will read it and just follow me from your Bible. And the king commanded all the people, saying, keep the Passover unto the Lord your God, as it is written in the book of this covenant. Surely there was not holden such a Passover from the days of the judges that judged Israel, nor in all the days of the kings of Israel, nor of the kings of Judah. But in the 18th year of King Josiah, wherein this Passover was holden to the Lord in Jerusalem. Moreover, the workers with familiar spirits, and the wizards, and the images, and the idols, and all the abominations that were spied in the land of Judah and in Jerusalem, did Josiah put away, that he might perform the words of the law, which were written in the book that Hilkiah the priest found in the house of the Lord. And like unto him was there no king before him that turned to the Lord with all his heart and with all his soul and with all his might according to all the law of Moses, neither after him arose there any like him. So obviously we're going to study today about the life of King Josiah. The Bible says that King Josiah is the king who strove to obey God from his youth. He is a person who in his heart there is that desire to honor the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. So we are going to consider in the scripture what the Bible says regarding this journey in life of King Josiah. So if we're going to cover all of these things, you will see some remarkable things on how Josiah actually became a good king. Because everything is against him. Everything, every circumstances does not favor him, but our God is a God that is above circumstances. So we should not allow circumstances to control us. If we will allow God to control our lives, then there is no circumstance that can pin us down and can destroy our faith in the Lord. So let us look at the history of the family of Josiah, at least from his great-great-grandfather until he came into being. Let us first look at 2 Kings chapter 16, verses 2 to 4, and we will look at his great-great-grandfather named Ahaz. Pangalang-pangalan pa lang. Amen. Ahaz. 2 Kings 16, 2 to 4. 20 years old was Ahaz when he began to reign, and reigned 16 years in Jerusalem. And he did not that which was right in the sight of the Lord his God, like David his father. In the Bible, when you look at the references regarding kings and regarding the things that they have done, you will always notice that David is part of the description. It is either they did what David did or they did not what David did. If they did good, then it will be mentioned like David. If they did bad, it will mention not like what David did in his life. Because David sort of became a standard for kings of Israel. If you follow David, then you're a good king. If you live up to the standard of David, then you are good. But if you fall under the standard of David, then you are an evil king. So we can see that Ahaz, even though his father, not actually the father, but from the lineage of David, he did that which was not that which was right in the sight of the Lord his God, like David his father. Verse number 3. But he walked in the way of the kings of Israel. Remember, during that time, there are two kingdoms, Israel and Judah. So we need to be reminded of that. Yea, and made his son to pass through the fire according to the abomination of the heathen whom the Lord cast out from before the children of Israel. So he did paganistic practices even though he was a king established by the Lord, God himself. Verse number 4. And he sacrificed and burnt incense in the high places. When you say high places, these are place of idolatry. And on the hills, and under every green tree. So we can see right away that the great-great-grandfather of Josiah was a godless man that led Judah into new levels of apostasy and idolatry. So we can see that during this time, Judah is under great apostasy and idolatry. But then again, God is a good God. Amen? He's a gracious God. He will always do something in order to give chances to his people. So when Ahaz died, he put on the throne King Hezekiah, the great grandfather of Josiah. Look at 2 Chronicles chapter 31, 20 and 21. And thus did Hezekiah throughout all Judah, and wrought that which was good and right and truth before the Lord his God. And in every work that he began in the service of the house of God, and in the law, and in the commandments, to seek his God, he did it with all his heart and prospered. So there was a break among the bad kings of Israel during the time of Hezekiah. Hezekiah reigned for 29 years from 716 BC to 687 BC. The Bible says that he reigned just after the Lord punished the northern kingdom because of their idolatry and because of their apostasy by using Assyria in order to destroy the people of God. So, as we saw during the time of Ahaz's reign, Judah had similarly gone into the negative way. And then following that is the reign of Hezekiah, where people saw the mercy of God. Because after the punishment, God wanted to rebuild his people. You see, God is always like that. There is what we call the principle of remnant. You cannot destroy. You cannot annihilate the people of God. You can destroy them, but they will not be annihilated. There will always be a remnant that will not bow to idolatry. There is always a remnant that will not bow to apostasy. There is always a remnant that is not going to serve the devil, but there will always be a remnant that is going to serve God. Amen. And even in our time, there will be a remnant that will not go into the way of worldliness, but will continue to serve God. Mga kapatid, let us realize that those that are negotiating the narrow way are few. And those that are negotiating the broad way are so many that we may not be able to count their numbers. But those that are walking through the straight gate or the narrow gate are only few. And that is the history of God's people. Until the millennium will come, we will always be in the minority. That is why in the Bible, we are commanded to be strong, to endure hardness. Why? The minority will experience that. We are not in control, and we do not want to be in control, because what we want is God to be in control. That is why no matter what we do, we'll never prosper until and unless it is according to the way of the Lord. So you can see that in the face of this stark warning from God, Hezekiah turned Judah away from their idols. What Hezekiah did is he broke down their images, their groves, and their altars, and he restored the proper order of the priests and work of the temple. So we can see that this spiritual revival was so remarkable because it included miracles wherein they were outnumbered, but they were able to destroy Assyria. Assyria is a very strong country, and they just came from the punishment of God. Therefore, they were decimated. They were outnumbered. But if God is there, there will always be victory, because greater is He that is in you than he that is in the world. If God be for us, then who can be against us? Let us be reminded of David when he defeated Goliath. Let us be reminded of Gideon's 300 when they fell the walls of Jericho. Let us be reminded of all of these people who were outnumbered, but because they were on the side of God, they gained victory given to them by the Lord. Amen? And not only that, it also included the very remarkable miracle in the life of Hezekiah when he was about to die, and he asked God to extend his life. And he was given another 15 years so that he can continually do good for the people of Judah. So the reign of Hezekiah is a good reign. It is a time of peace because the Assyrians were held back by the Lord. It is a time of prosperity because as they obey God, God will bless them. That is true to Israel. Your obedience will have a blessing that includes material blessing, but not in our time today. Our blessing today are spiritual, and material things are just a bonus. If God would like to give us more in our area of stewardship. And it is a time of what we call a spiritual revival. But then, before the end of the life of Hezekiah, when there was no more threat from Assyria, you will see that slowly they are going back to idolatry. They are going back to apostasy just before the death and after the death of Hezekiah. So you will see that our propensity is to do evil, not to do good. We may be worshiping God, but our flesh is still desiring to do that which is not good. That is why it is very common, it is very normal, though should not, that Christians are still committing sin in their lives. Why? Because there is that what we call old Adamic nature that is pulling us towards sin. They are at a more disadvantage than us. At least we Christians, we have the new nature. Once we feed the new nature and it will become stronger than the old Adamic nature, we can tip the scale towards what is right, doing what is good, doing what will glorify God. Remember, in the Old Testament, they do not have the Spirit of God. They only have the flesh. So no matter what happened, even though they are worshiping God, still the flesh is there. And the flesh is continually pulling them towards sin. So that is why when prosperity came, they became relaxed. When there was no threat from Assyria, they said everything is well, we can do what we want to do in our lives. So remember, the main motivation in the Old Testament is fear. It is fear. They fear that God will punish them. They fear that God will destroy them. They fear that God will not bless them. So that is the main motivation. So when there is no more fear, they will revert back to doing evil in the sight of God. But in our time, our motivation is love. And love is a greater motivation than fear. That's why the Bible says, God has not given us the spirit of fear. Amen? But He was given us the spirit of power, of love, and of a sound mind. So after the reign of Hezekiah came Manasseh. Manasseh now is the grandfather of Josiah. Manasseh reigned for 55 years. Mahaba yung reign niya. From 687 BC to 642 BC. Ito mga hari talaga, noong unang panahon, ano sila, no? BC. Hindi sila mga tamad na tao, kaya siguro naging hari itong mga ito eh. Because they're always BC. They're doing something and not just sitting down. While Hezekiah was remarkably good and faithful and godly and caused Judah to do what is right in the sight of the Lord, Manasseh, on the other hand, was more evil than all the kings who came before him. Ito yung isa sa pinaka masama na hari nung panahon niya kesa rin sa mga naunang hari bago si Manasseh. Bakit? Anong ginawa niya? 2 Kings chapter 21, 1 to 17. I will read this, follow me, and you will see how evil Manasseh was. Manasseh was 12 years old when he began to reign, and reigned 55 years in Jerusalem, and his mother's name was Hephzibah. And he did that which was evil in the sight of the Lord after the abominations of the heathen whom the Lord cast out before the children of Israel. So bumalik siya doon sa bago si Hezekiah. Kung ano yung nangyari nung time ni Ahaz, ibinalik niya. For he built up again. See? Those that were destroyed were built up again. The high places which Hezekiah his father had destroyed. And he reared up altars for Baal and made a grove, as did Ahab, king of Israel, and worship all the hosts of heaven and serve them. Horoscope. Hosts of heaven. Ngayong araw na ito, matatagpuan mo ang hinahanap mo. So, paglabas niya, tingin ng tingin. Matatagpuan daw eh. Darating siya sa buhay mo ngayon. Yung mga mahilig sa ano eh, horoscope eh. Mamalasing ka ngayong araw na ito. Ay, hindi ako lalabas, kanya. Hindi pumasok, walang ginawa. Sabi niya, mag-aalas 12 na, lagpas ako, walang malas na dumating. Bago mag-alas 12, may kumatok. Pagbukas niya, binan niya. Ayun, yung malas na inabot niya. So, horoscope. And he built altars in the house of the Lord. See? He built altars in the house of the Lord, of which the Lord said, in Jerusalem will I put my name. He desecrated the name of God. Because instead of God being worshipped in the house of the Lord, pagan gods are now being worshipped in that place. Tuloy lang. He made his son pass through fire and observed times and used enchantments and dealt with familiar spirits and wizards. He wrote much wickedness in the sight of the Lord to provoke him to anger. It is as if he's really challenging God. Verse 7. And he set a graven image of the grove that he had made in the house of which the Lord said to David and to Solomon his son, in this house and in Jerusalem, which I have chosen out of all the tribes of Israel, will I put my name forever. God repeat this verse in order to emphasize that in the temple, only God's name will be used. But Manasseh disobeyed God and desecrated the name of God and made this place desolate again and again and again. Neither will I make the feet of Israel move anymore out of the land which I gave their fathers, only if they will observe to do according to all that I have commanded them, and according to all the law that my servant Moses commanded them. Verse 9. But they hearkened not, and Manasseh seduced them to do more evil than did the nations whom the Lord destroyed before the children of Israel. This is the danger of one man rule. This is the danger of that. One man can make a country great, and one man can make a country be destroyed. So that's why they say that everything rises and falls on leadership. That may be true, but if you will make leadership more, and if you will make leadership spiritual, then most probably things will rise because of good leadership. Amen. And that is how God wanted it to be. But they hearken not. And the Lord spake by his servants the prophets, saying, because Manasseh king of Judah had done these abominations and had done wickedly above all that the Amorites did. See? Yung ginagawa ni Manasseh, mapapahiya ang mga pagano. Walang sinabi mga Amorites. Ang Amorites, ano yan? Pagano yan, sumasapa sa Diyos-Diyosan, masasamang tao, pero the Bible says, because Manasseh king of Judah had done these abominations and had done wickedly above all that the Amorites did, which were before him, and that made Judah also to sin with his idols. 12. Therefore, thus saith the Lord God of Israel, behold, I am bringing such evil upon Jerusalem and Judah that whosoever heareth of it, both his ears shall tingle. Yung gagawin ko kanya sa Jerusalem at sa Judah, kung may makakarinig, yung tenga nila mismo ay maapektuhan. Yung parang, you will not believe what God is going to do to His own people, to Jerusalem and Judah. And I will stretch over Jerusalem the line of Samaria and the plummet of the house of Ahab. And I will wipe Jerusalem as a man wipeth a dish, wiping it and turning it upside down. Biro mo, nadamay tayong mga lalaki dito sa kasalanan ng ni Manasseh. Dito nagsimula na ang lalaki naghuhugas ng plato, balik mo. And I will wipe Jerusalem as a man wipeth a dish. Biblical po mga kapatid. Maghugas ng plato. Amen? Eh no. As a man wipeth a dish, wiping it, tinuro pa, and turning it upside down. Wag lang dito ang hugas, babalik ta rin mo. Huhugasan mo pa rin doon. Amen? And ebidensya yan. Wala. Actually, mga kapatid, nung pinag-aaralan ko, gusto kong lagpasan. Sabi ko, wag ko kayong basahin to. Kasi pangahawakan to ng mga babae. Delikado tayo rito. Pero, dahil biblical tayo, susunod tayo, amen? Na ito ay metaphor lang. Hindi totoo. I-describe lang kung paanong lilinisin ng Diyos ang Israel. Katulad ng paghuhugas ng plato. Tuloy. Maliwanag yan. And I will forsake the remnant of mine inheritance and deliver them into the hand of their enemies, and they shall become a prey and a spoil to all their enemies. Even the remnant will be put under exile because of the sin of Manasseh. Because they have done that which was evil in my sight and have provoked me to anger since the day of their fathers came forth out of Egypt, even unto this day. Biblical din kasi yun eh. Kita mo, Panginoon, pag nagalit. Sabi niya, mga suwail kayo! Mula pa nung sa inyong mga ama, nung paalayain ko kayo sa Egypt. Kaya pag nag-aaway, talagang pati yung kauna-unahang panahon. Binabanggit, di ba? Ito yun eh. Nung bago pa lang tayong ikasal, ayun. 30 taon ng kasal. Ay, hindi ba? Ganyan talaga eh. Biblical naman pala yung mga bagay. Andain natin natututunan, mga kapatid. Ano? Their fathers came forth out of Egypt even to this day. Hanggang ngayon, kaya ng Panginoon. Moreover, Manasseh, tingnan nyo ito ha, shed innocent blood very much till he had filled Jerusalem from one end to another. kung yun daw dugo ng mga pinatay ni Manase ay maidudugtong mo yung Jerusalem mula sa simula hanggang sa dulo ng Jerusalem. Ganyan kasama ito si ano, si Manase. Beside his sin, wherewith he made Judah to sin in doing that which was evil in the sight of the Lord. 17. Now the rest of the acts of Manasseh, hindi pa kompleto yan, and all that he did, and his sin that he sinned, are they not written in the book of the Chronicles of the Kings of Judah? So you see that the Manasseh, the grandfather of Josiah, was so evil that God caused him to destroy, or that he's going to destroy Jerusalem and Judah, and nobody will be able to stop that. Meaning to say, it was already pronounced by God, and there is no way that it will never happen. He is going to destroy these two countries or these two kingdoms, and he's going to even put the remnant under exile because of the sin of Manasseh. And then Manasseh died. Amen? Praise God. But came Amon, the father of Josiah. And look at the description of the Bible when it comes to Amon. Look at 2 Kings. Nawala yung verse ko. Tuloy na lang natin. 19. Amon was 22 years old when he began to reign. And he reigned 2 years, dalawang taon lang, in Jerusalem. And his mother's name was Mesulemet, the daughter of Haruz of Jotba. And he did that which was evil in the sight of the Lord, as his father Manasseh did. Tuloy. And he walked in all the way that his father walked in, and served the idol that his father served, and worshipped them. Paglaki ko, gagayahin ko ang tatay ko. Amen. Biblical din yan. Nakasulat sa Bible, ipinatalasta sa Pilipinas. Tuloy. And he forsook the Lord God of his fathers and walked not in the way of the Lord. And the servants of Ammon conspired against him and slew the king in his own house. Alam nyo, minsan, if you are so evil, sometimes people will not even, they will not be able to stomach that. And they will do something and put things into their own hands in order to end your life. So, Amon was so evil that people says, we cannot bear this anymore. Even his own servants, they conspired and they killed Amon. That is the reason why he reigned for only 2 years. Don't you notice that those evil kings reigned for longer times than good kings? If you will notice that. Why? Hindi ba sabi sa Pilipinas, ang masamang damo, matagal mamatay. And they were being protected by the devil in order for them to continue their evil ways. So, the great-great-grandfather was evil, the great-grandfather good, the grandfather so much evil, and then the father did the same thing and was very evil. And then after that came into the scene Josiah. And he became king at 8 years old. And he reigned for 31 years. So batang namatay si ano? Josiah. 39 years old nung siya ay mamatay. But ladies and gentlemen, listen to me. It is not how long that we live, but if we allow our days to count for God. Yun yung pinag-uusapan. Nabuhay ka nga ng 70 years, 70 years naman nakasamaan. Nabuhay ka nga ng 10 taon, 10 taon naman nakabutihan. So it will count. Hindi yung longevity, but the quality of life that we have shown towards God. So we can see that, like his grandfather Hezekiah, Josiah led a spiritual revival in Judah. But again, it was too late, because God already pronounced the judgment to Jerusalem and Judah. So sometimes, even no matter what we do, chastisement will come. What we have sown, we will reap. Even though God may postpone it, give us more grace, but whatever we have sown, the Bible says, we are going to reap. And that happened in the life of Judah. So now we will go to our message about the life of King Hezekiah. Let us look at Hezekiah, Josiah, when he came into the throne. Number one, he started seeking the Lord in the strength of his youth. He started seeking the Lord in the strength of his youth. 2 Chronicles 34:1-7. Josiah was 8 years old when he began to reign, and he reigned in Jerusalem 130 years. And he did that which was right in the sight of the Lord, and walked in the ways of David. Ayan na naman, di ba? And walked in the ways of David his father. You see, laging David his father. Hindi niya tatay yun. Sa Hebrew, ano kasi, sa Hebrew language at saka grammar, pwedeng tawaging father kahit na gano'n nakalayo sa linya. Kahit si Adam, pwede mo tawaging father. Kung kaya nga, galing tayo sa linya niya. So, hindi ibig sabihin, ang tatay niya ay si ano? David. Walk in the ways of his of David his father, and declined neither to the right hand nor to the left. So we can see that he traveled the straight way. There was no swerving during the life of Josiah. It is all in all for God. It is all in all according to what God wanted him to do in his life. And we will notice something. That is why the desire of Josiah is very remarkable. Because later on, we will look at his circumstances. Look at verse number 3. For in the 8th year of his reign, while he was yet young, so 8 years siya nag-reign, mag-start mag-reign, and then nung 8 years, so ilang taon na siya? 16. While he was yet young, he began to seek after the God of David, his father. And in the 12th year, 20 years old na siya, he began to purge Judah and Jerusalem from the high places and the groves and the carved images and the molten images. And they break down the altars of Baalim in his presence, and the images that were on high above them he cut down, and the groves and the carved images and the molten images he break in pieces, and made dust of them and strode it upon the graves of them that had sacrificed unto them. And he burnt the bones of the priests upon their altars and cleansed Judah and Jerusalem. Matindi, no? And so did he in the cities of Manasseh and Ephraim and Simeon, even unto Naphtali, with their mattocks round about. And verse 7, and when he had broken down the altars and the groves, and had beaten the graven images into powder, hindi lang binasag. Pinulbus niya. And cut down all the idols throughout all the land of Israel, he returned to Jerusalem. So we can see that the circumstances of Josiah is not good. Why? His father, his grandfather was evil. Great evil he did in his life. His father was evil. So he saw all of these things. From 2 years old until 6 years old, he saw what his grandfather did. And from 7 to 8 years old, he saw what his father did. He was surrounded by negative circumstances. He was surrounded by evil. He was surrounded by paganism, idolatry, apostasy. Name the sin, and he was exposed to that kind of sin. This is the circumstance of Josiah. But in spite of this, listen, he was able to rise up into the occasion. Amen. We do not know why. He did not get that from the father. He did not get that from the grandfather. He did not get that from his... You see, if you're a king and you're 8 years old, you cannot really reign. Some people will handle you. So he has handlers. And all of these handlers came from Manasseh and Ammon. And all of these are evil. So you will see that from 8 years old until he was 16 years old, no reform is happening. Wala nangyayari. Tuloy lang ang buhay. Idolatry is still rampant. Apostasy is still there. All evil things are still happening when he was 8 years old until he was before 16 or 16 years. So nothing actually changes. Why? Because it was part of the what you call punishment of God to a country that forsake the Lord. Look at Ecclesiastes chapter 10, verse 16. This is in the Bible. Ecclesiastes 10:16. Woe to thee, O land, when thy king is a child. See? Woe to thee, O land, when thy king is a child. Why did it happen? Because he went into the throne not in due season. Why? Because something happened before him. Why? Because evil must be cut off by God, so they were cut off prematurely, and the people who should get the throne were put into the throne prematurely. That's why God says, woe to thee, O land, when thy king is a child and thy princes eat in the morning. So when King Josiah was young, he cannot do anything, but he is at the mercy of his handlers. But look at verse number 17. Blessed art thou, O land, when thy king is the son of nobles and thy princes eat in due season. Right time. They will take the throne at the right time for strength and not for drunkenness. They are not foolish anymore. They are already matured. They know what they are doing by the grace of God. So what happened to Judah? They mourned because their king was young. But their mourning was turned into joy when Josiah reached age 16. Amen? So there is always a time. Wait. Do not be in a hurry. Sometimes things may not be according to how we want them to be. But if God is working and God is doing something, time will come that everything will be according to the plan of God. Amen? So naghintay si Josiah. But where did Josiah get this? His mother was not mentioned that she did evil in the sight of the Lord. So there might be a small chance that the mother instilled something good in Josiah. Because no matter how we look at it, the first influence that a child will get is from the mother. Especially when the king was busy. Amen? He was given to the care of the mother, and maybe the mother loved God. Because the name of his mother is Jedidah, if I'm not mistaken, and it means beloved. So it has a positive connotation. So maybe the desire in Josiah's heart to seek after the God of David was instilled by the mother when he was yet still young. So we can see that these things happened because of the sins of the two kings before Josiah. But praise God, because our God is mighty to save. Amen. Even though the circumstances are dark, even though the circumstances are bleak, God was able to penetrate, get through, and he was able to get a hold of the heart of Josiah. Amen. Notice two things, very important. It doesn't matter if you live in a dire circumstances. It doesn't matter if you are surrounded by evil. You can always rise up into the occasion if you're going to focus your mind on the Lord. Hindi porket masama ang paligid mo, masama ka na. Hindi porket walang sumasampa sa Diyos, hindi ka sasampa sa Diyos. Hindi porket unbeliever ang mga magulang mo, hindi ka pwedeng maging believer. There is always a way that God will help those people who really wanted to seek the will of God in their life. Number two, do not take for granted that our children grow or grew in a good circumstance. Remember, Manasseh grew under Hezekiah, and Hezekiah was a good king. But after him, Manasseh became the most evil of all the kings in Israel. Don't take for granted, well, my child or my children grew in the church. It doesn't mean that they're going to become a Christian. It doesn't mean that they're going to grow as a good citizen of the country. It doesn't mean that they're going to be okay. We have to be very diligent in explaining to them the word of God, in explaining to them the will of God, in explaining to them salvation. Be sure and see to it that they will be wise like Timothy unto salvation from a child. Do not take things for granted. Huwag mo hindi, bahalaan si Pastor dyan. Naririnig niya linggo-linggo yun. Malilit kasi yan, no. Hindi porket maganda sirkumstansya. Kasi kahit gaano maganda sirkumstansya, nagawa ang Diablo. Kahit pangit ang sirkumstansya, nagawa ang Diablo. And God is also working things for our good. Amen? So wag tayong magtiwala sa mga pangyayari, magtiwala tayo doon sa mga bagay na sigurado. So those are the things that we need to understand and the things that we need to emphasize. Look at 2 Kings 22:1. Ito pala yung nanay ni ni Josiah. Josiah was 8 years old when he began to reign, and he reigned 31 years in Jerusalem, and his mother's name was Jedidah, the daughter of Adaiah of Boscath. Yung Jedidah, ang ibig sabihin niyan ay beloved. So there is a good news. As I said a while ago, that she's the one who instilled those good qualities in the life of or in the heart of Josiah when he was still young. Okay, look at Lamentations 3:27. So at the young age, Josiah used it in order for him to seek God. In Lamentations 3:27, the Bible says, "It is good for a man that he bear the yoke in his youth." You see, sometimes we look at youth as a time to seek after thrills, or a time to, do the things that will make us happy. It doesn't matter if they are good. It doesn't matter if they are bad. But ladies and gentlemen, what you do in your youth will bear heavily on what you're going to be when you become an adult. Kung ginagawa mo ng bata, kakala mo harmless, malaking bagay yan sa pagtanda mo. Dahil yun yung nakasanayan mo, yun yung kabataan mo, yun yung yun ang ibinuhay mo nung bata ka. Yun yung ginawa mong foundation sa iyong buhay. So you cannot say that I will enjoy my youth and when I'm old I'm going to serve God. Everybody who said that end up in hell. Why? Jeremiah says in Lamentation, "It is good for a man that he bear the yoke in his youth." While you are still retractable, while you are still pliable, these things must be given to the youth so that they will understand their responsibility even though they are young. And this is what happened to Josiah. He bore the yoke in his youth, and because of that, he became a good king. But those other kings who did not bear the yoke in their youth, they became evil. Why? Because that is all the things that they have done when they were young. Huwag tayong maniwala sa sanlibutan. Enjoy mo yung kabataan mo. Sige, if it feels good, do it. Kasi pagtanda mo, hindi mo na magagawa yun. Lalo mo nga gagawin yun kasi ginawa mo nung bata ka. Lalo mo nga gagawin yun kasi ganun ka nung bata ka. Ano ba naman nung bata ka, pagtanda mo, nag-iba ka? Bihira yun. At yun ay man's will. It is not God's will. At yun ay will of the flesh. It is not the will of the spirit. So what is that yoke? That yoke, I believe, was responsibility and discipline. Because he sought the Lord for 8 years in the midst of an evil generation. Hindi ba nakita ang gano'ng kahirap yun? Yung saliksikin mo ang Diyos sa gitna ng masamang henerasyon. Eh nung na-save ka lang, pupunta ka ng church, ano sabi sa'yo? Hoy, saan ka pupunta? Baka mapasok ka. Pagpasok mo ron, di ba? Hindi ka titigilan. May dala kang Bible. Naku po, magugunaw na ang mundo. Nagdadala siya ng Bible. Narinig niya yun, mga bago tayong Kristiyano eh. Ay, yun eh. Patutsyada lang yan. Paano pa kaya ito? When everybody, tignan nyo ha, he was a king, he has handlers, everybody wanted the throne. So if they will see that he's not going with the mainstream, they can easily kill him and get the throne from him. But he bore the yoke in his youth. And in his heart, he tried to search for God. Pastor, ba't hindi na lang niya basahin ang mga ang commands, ang first, ang Pentateuch? Wala hong noon. Hindi kumpleto ang Book of Moses noon. Bakit nung time ni Manasseh tsaka ni Amon, binastos nila yung temple? At lahat ng may kinalaman sa Diyos, most probably, tinapon yun o sinunog yun. Because they do not want to retain God in their midst. So there is no way that Josiah can know God by reading the Word of God. Because there was no such thing during that time. The only light during that time was Jeremiah, because he was contemporary with Josiah. That's why most of Lamentations, some verses in Lamentation is about Josiah. Kasi contemporary nga sila ni Jeremiah. And Jeremiah was a weeping prophet because almost nobody believed him. So there is little possibility that Josiah even heard about Jeremiah during this particular time. So we can see that it is good, ladies and gentlemen, train up a child in the way that he should go. And when he is old, he will not depart from it. Dito tayo, mahinang mga magulang. Andali natin disiplinahin ang ibang bata. Pagdating sa ating sariling anak, hindi natin kaya. Ang discernment natin sira pagdating sa ating mga anak. Why? Kasi sa isip natin, hindi gagawin ng anak ko yan. Kilala ko yan. Hindi natin kilala anak natin. Hindi natin kilala ang lubusan ng Diablo kung anong pwede niyang gawin sa ating mga anak. Kaya kayong mga magulang na, hindi, mahal na mahal ko ang anak ko, hindi ko kayang paluin yan, hindi mo mahal. Marunong ka pa ba sa Diyos na nagsulat kung paano didisiplinahin ang mga bata? Mas marunong ka ba? Ay, diyan ko, Pastor, hindi ko pinalo anak, pero kita mo, lumaking maayos, edi mas magaling ka pa sa Diyos. Ano? Magaling ka pa sa Diyos. Hindi mo sinabi niya, pero lumaki ang anak mo ng maayos. Hindi. That is pride and rebellion against God. Foolishness is bound in the heart of a child, and only the rod of correction will drive it away from him. Or him, Brad. Biblical na biblical. Hindi ba? Yun ang maglalayo. Sa foolishness, sa heart ng bata, kaya disiplinahin yan. Paluin yan kung kailangan. At dapat, na sa ganun matuto. Dahil kung hindi natin gagawin, Pastor, kita mo naman ang liit-liit, ang cute-cute, batang-bata, paparuhin ko. Anak ni Janice yan. Kahit gaano pa ka-cute yan. Demonyito't demonyita yan. Para sabihin ko sa inyo, dahil wala pa dyan ang Espiritu ng Diyos. Ang default niyan, mali. Eh, kababata pa, sumasagot na yun. Kanya lang ganun eh. Eh kung may salita lang yun, baka pinagmumura na tayo, hindi pa natin alam. So, let them bear the yoke. The yoke. I know that's different. Ang lakas mo makahawa kasi. Terrible ka. Sabi niya kagabi, Pastor, ano kasi yung different? Nag-i-scrabble sila, tumira ng HE. Ano yan, he? Kanya. Hahanapin pa sa dictionary eh. Ay, nako. Sa bagay, kirinate ng Diyos yung mga Bisaya, ala tayong magagawa. So let them bear the yoke. Amen? In their youth. Huwag kang maawa ka sa anak mo, paluin mo kapatid. Huwag kang maawa na hindi mo papaluin. And then, while they are growing up, pakita na natin yung responsibility. Pakita na natin yung authority. Nang sa ganung pag ipinaliwanag natin ng Diyos, alam na nila yung concept of authority and they can easily believe God. That is training them to become a child of God. That's why, you know what the Bible says? Timothy was made wise unto salvation from a child. He was made wise unto salvation. Ano ibig sabihin? Naging matalino siya para sa kaligtasan. Why? He was trained about authority. He was trained about obedience. He was trained about the Word of God. And it was so easy for him to repent of his sins and receive Jesus as his Savior. Why? Because he was trained as a child. So let them bear these things in their youth. Amen? The yoke. Kasi yoke, youth. Yoke, youth. Yoke, youth. Yoke, youth. Oo, ayan, sinasabi ko, palasagot ka. Okay. Listen, there is a quotation here by Matthew Henry. It says, "Happy and wise are those who seek the Lord and prepare for usefulness at an early age." Di ba ang ganda? Bata pa, piniprepare mo na para mapakinabangan. "When others are pursuing sinful pleasures, contracting bad habits, and forming ruinous associations, who can express the anguish prevented by early piety and its blessed effects?" Yung bata pa lang, nakilala na ang Diyos. Yung bata pa lang, natuto na sa mga gawi ng Diyos. Kita mo, sabi nga nila minsan, kung sino pa yung mga anak ng pastor, sila pa yung mga maluloko. Eh, kita mo nga, punong-puno na ng Word of God eh. Eh, paano pa kaya yung hindi? Oh, isipin natin mabuti mga kapatid. Linggo-linggo na nasa simbahan. Wala nang naririnig kundi salita ng Diyos. May devotion pa sa bahay. May sermonan pa. Ang dami. Oh, pero ano? Pasaway. Di ba? Sila pa yung mga pinakamalalaking kasalanan gagawin sa loob ng simbahan. Di ba? Eh, paano pa yung hindi? Ang tingin kayo kay Amiel? Dito tingin ako nagpipreach eh. Itong mga taong to. Puro kay judgmental. Ha, Brad? Oh. Pero totoo yung Brad, sinasabi ko. Hindi, totoo yung sinasabi ko sa principle dito. Diligent self-examination and watchfulness will convince us of the deceitfulness and wickedness of our own hearts and sinfulness of our hearts. You know, the reason why we are always falling into sin is because we are being deceived by our hearts. Kaya yung follow your heart, nako. Paluin mo yung heart mo, yun, oo. Pero yung follow your heart, no. Follow the Lord, not your heart. So, because of all the things that Josiah did, he was rewarded by God. Look at 2 Chronicles 34:8 to 18. Sabi niyo ba, dami naman yan. "Now in the 18th year of his reign," ilan taon na siya dyan? 26. Kasi 8 siya nung nag-reign. Nung 18 taon ng kanyang pagre-reign, 26 na siya. "When he had purged the land and the house," so nag-start pa lang siya ng reform nung 26. Nakita niya? Ay 16, tapos pinakamatindi yung 26. So ibig sabihin talagang minsan ang pagbabago mabagal. Huwag natin minsan minamadaling mga tao. Kaliligtas, nakakailang buwan, nakakailang taon, bagamat hindi natin iniikis ang kasalanan, sabi na ganyan natin, hindi ka siguro ligtas. Huwag agad-agad. Paalalaan na natin, yes. Pero huwag natin i-judge. Kasi meron talagang minsan mabagal yung pagbabago. Minsan mabagal yung reform. Minsan naman mabilis. So, may mga individual differences tayo. "Now, in the 18th year of his reign, when he had purged the land and the house, he sent Shaphan." So, from ano pala, 16 years old to 25, pinagigiba niya yung mga ano, yung mga groves, etc. Ngayon naman, "he sent Shaphan, the son of Azaliah, and Maaseiah, the governor of the city, and Joah, the son..." Joah, talagang Bible din to eh. "Joah, the son of Joahas, the recorder, to repair the house of the Lord, his God." So, 26 years old siya nung i-repair niya yung ano, house of the Lord. Ang ginawa niya, kita nyo, ano sabi ni Jeremiah? Destroy, di ba? Pull out, and then build. So, ganyan ginawa niya. Pinagsisira niya muna yung mga ano, idolatry, lahat ng apostasy, lahat ng mga mali, bago siya ni-rebuild yung house of the Lord. Tuloy. Tuloy-tuloy na tayo, Milka. 9. "And when they came to Hilkiah, the high priest, they delivered the money that was brought into the house of God, which the Levites that kept the doors had gathered of the hand of Manasseh and Ephraim, and of all the remnant of Israel, and of all Judah and Benjamin, and they returned to Jerusalem." So, nangolekta na sila ng pera para i-rebuild yung ano, temple. "And they put it in the hand of the workmen that had the oversight of the house of the Lord, and they gave it to the workmen that wrought in the house of the Lord to repair and amend the house. So actually, refurbish yan. Inayos nila. Even to the artificers and builders gave they it to buy hewn stone and timber for couplings and to floor the house which the kings of Judah had destroyed. Maraming sinira. And the men did the work faithfully. Amen. And the overseers of them were Jahat and Obadiah, the Levites of the sons of Merari, and Zechariah and Meshulam, and the sons of the Kohathites, to set it forward, and other of the Levites, all that could skill of instruments of music. And they were over the bearers of the burdens, and were overseers of all that wrought the work in any manner of service, and the Levites there were scribes and officers and porters. And when they brought out the money that was brought into the house of the Lord, Hilkiah the priest found the book of the law of the Lord given by Moses. Dito pa lang. Walang book noon. There is no Bible. There are no parchments. There are no scrolls during the time of Josiah. That is why it is very, very remarkable how Josiah sought the Lord without the aid of the Word of God. And that is also the reason why the Reformation was very slow, because Josiah is only acting according to his own knowledge and conscience. Walang guidance ng Word of God. Ang kanya, pure na, hindi, palagay ko masama itong mga ito. Pagigiba ko to. Mali itong mga ito. Ipasisira ko to. Yun lang ang ginagawa ni Josiah. From 16 years old until he was 26 years old, because there was no book of the Lord. And Hilkiah delivered the book to Shaphan. And Shaphan carried the book to the king and brought the king word back again saying, all that was committed to thy servants, they do it. And they have gathered together the money that was found in the house of the Lord and have delivered it unto the hand of the overseers and to the hand of the workmen. Then Shaphan the scribe told the king saying, Hilkiah the priest had given me a book, and Shaphan read it before the king. So before this, we can see Psalms 133 verse 1 in action. How good and how pleasant it is for brethren to dwell together in unity. Amen? Did you see the unity? From the officers to the workmen, from the simple people to the nobles, all of them are working together. Isn't it good to see a church working together for the glory of God? Josiah caused them to do that. Why? Because Josiah decided to do what is right in the sight of the Lord. And when he did that, the people followed him. Mga kapatid, kung ang ginagawa natin tama, maganda, sumunod na ho kayo nang magkaisa tayo sa tama at maganda na ating ginagawa. You see, we are not doing this for the sake of being argumentative, or we're not doing this for the sake of just raising up an issue. No, we're doing this because God is giving us light regarding these things. Magpapasidetrack lang ako ng konti. Meron na namang issue ngayon, yung Bill de Abante, yung gagawing mandatory ang Bible reading sa lahat ng public school from elementary until high school. If you will look at it, it is a good bill. Amen. Because the Bible will be read. But you do not look at the face value. You look at the Word of God. Ano sabi natin? Testing mind set. We must test everything according to the Word of God. If we're going to test that bill using the Word of God and history of Baptist, we will see that it is not agreeable to the Word of God and to our history. Why? Number one, as Baptists, we believe in the separation of church and state. We do not sponsor a statewide bill or law. Because number two, we believe in individual soul liberty. We, even though we do not agree with the Muslims, we do not agree with many Christian religions, we do not agree with atheists, we respect men because they were given free will by God. And God is the one that will judge them in due time. We are not the ones. Number two, historically, the reason why Baptists were persecuted is because of legislations. Because we believe in the separation of church and state, we do not combine the two. And this law will make this reading of God's word enforceable. So the question is, what will the government do to those who will not read the Bible? Biro mo, kulong yan, di nagbabasa ng Bible. May. We are destroying the image of God. God will give a command. God will give a precept, a principle. And it is up to us to obey it or not. Even Israel was given that chance. Even Joshua said, choose you this day whom ye will serve. How long had she between two opinions? It was given to man. And we have no right to curtail the free will of men. Hindi nila maintindihan yan. Number three, pwede pala yung maging batas. E ano kung nag-promulgate naman ng Muslim? Nasabihin naman niya, mandatory reading of the Quran in all public school. E di, dalawa na babasahin. Bible, Quran, ano na nangyari sa mga tao? E alin ba talaga? Sino ba talaga? Oh. Binasa ko yung bill. Meron palang provision na ganito. If you're a Muslim, you must read the Quran, study the Quran, examine the Quran. If you're a Christian, read the Bible, study the Bible, examine the Bible. Ang mga problema ito, anong version ng Bible? Pag Baptist ka, anong para sa atin, anong Bible? King James. E paano kung binasa NIV? Ah, okay ba yun? ESV. Kung binasa VST and Company. Alam niyo yung VST, yung version? Ahitin mo at lagyan ng pulbos. Ano ba yung kanta nila Tito Vic and Joey? Kung yun ang binasa na version? Nagdala ng mga Bible yung mga bata. Okay, children, let us read John 3:16. Eh, ibang version? Sabi nito. Di lalo na kung ano sabi ng mga estudyante? Kagulo naman pala ng Bible? Kagulo naman pala ng pananampalataya na yan? Maging 80s na lang nga tayo, wala pang gulo. O, see? Andang makikreate na ano? Confusion. Bakit? Kasi meron ng panukala ang Diyos, pinakikialaman pa natin. Akala natin kaya nating tulungan ng Diyos. Yung sinabi ng Diyos, sapat na yun. Hindi kailangan ng Diyos ang tulong natin. Ang kailangan ng Diyos, availability natin na sundin yung kalooban niya. Hindi gagawa ka ng batas para sa Diyos. Ang Diyos ang tagagawa ng batas, hindi tayo. Tayo tagasunod sa batas ng Diyos. Amen? So those are the things that will be created because of this law. And because I commented that, I'm just waiting later on. Siguradong yayariin na naman ako ng mga ano, ng mga kabig niya. Sasabihin, kasi si Abante na gano'n, kaya kontra ka. Hindi ho eh. Yung history, yung Bible, yung pwedeng maging resulta ng mga bagay na ginagawa. As Baptists, listen, we persuade, we do not force. Right? We persuade, we do not force. Hindi tayo namimilit, nagpapaliwanag tayo at nangungumbinsi tayo. Hindi natin tinatakot. Pag di ka nabasa ng Bible, kukulong ka. Another reason, biblical reason, the natural man cannot receive the things of the Spirit of God, for they are spiritually discerned. Basahin niya man ang Bible from cover to cover and save siya, hindi niya maiintindihan. Nakikreate pa yan ng maraming kulto. Number four, paano kung ang teacher member ng dating daan? Hindi, ito yung mga mangyayari. Teacher ako, member ako ng dating daan, binasa Bible, paano kong i-interpret? Ayon sa turo ni Soriano. Ang teacher iglesia ni Cristo. Manapa kung lahat ng teacher, Baptist, may turo yung tama, paano kung hindi? Confusion. Paano sa klase, 45 Kristiyano, 5 Muslim? Paano yung 5? Hindi, may sariling magpapaliwanag, hindi dalawa teacher dapat, lumaki pa gastos ang gobyerno. These things will destroy. what God is trying to build. That's why we must always be according to the Word of God. Do this in the realm of the Spirit, and let us be united in proclaiming the Word of God. Amen? So, yun yung ating dapat gawin. So, when this book of the law came into being, they're doing good things, they're doing what is right, and then the law, the book of the law was found, and it was read to Josiah. First time palang maririnig ni Josiah sa buhay niya ang Word of God. Mula nang siya ipanganak. Ngayon palang niya maririnig. And binasa, 2 Kings 22:11 to 20. Lapit na, mga 3 chapters na lang. And it came to pass when the king had heard the words of the book of the law that he rent his clothes. See? Pagkabasang pagkabasa ng Bible kay Josiah, ng Word of God kay Josiah, ano ginawa niya? Pinunit niya ang damit niya. Nabasag ang puso niya. He was brokenhearted when he heard for the first time the Word of God. He rent his clothes. And he was so brokenhearted. Why? Ba't nangyari yun? Tuloy natin. And the king commanded Hilkiah the priest and Ahikam the son of Shaphan and Akbor the son of Micaiah and Shaphan the scribe and Asahiah a servant of the king saying, go ye, inquire of the Lord for me and for the people and for all Judah concerning the words of this book that is found. For great is the wrath of the Lord that is kindled against us. Nakita niya kung gaano ang galit ng Diyos sa kanila. In the midst of the reform, God is still wrath against Israel. Galit pa rin ng Diyos. In the midst of the... Nasa reform, dapat yung binabasa sa kanya, ay, praise God, ginagawa ko na. Ay, praise God, hallelujah, we are on the right track. But no, it affected his heart. And he said that the wrath of God, great wrath of God, was kindled against us because of our fathers have not hearkened unto the words of this book to do according unto all that which is written concerning us. You see, look at the word, unto all that which is written concerning us. The Word of God is not selective. It must be taken as a whole. Tuloy, Milka. So Hilkiah the priest and Ahikam and Akbor and Shaphan and Asahiah went unto Huldah the prophetess, the wife of Shallum, the son of Tikva, the son of Harshas, keeper of the wardrobe. Now she dwelt in Jerusalem in the college and they communed with her. May college of ano kasi, prophets and prophetess. Hindi school, parang school nga, na doon sila nagkakaroon ng pagtitipon. And she said unto them, thus saith the Lord God of Israel, tell the man that sent you to me, pertaining to Josiah, thus saith the Lord, behold, I will bring evil upon this place. Wala na eh. Hindi mo na mapiprevent kasi sinabi na ng Diyos yun eh. I will bring evil upon this place and upon the inhabitants thereof, even all the words of the book which the king of Judah hath read. All of those I will do, sabi ng Diyos. Because they have forsaken me and have burned incense unto other gods that they might provoke me to anger with all the works of their hands, therefore my wrath shall be kindled against this place and shall not be quenched. Hindi na makukwench, sabi niya, hindi titigil yung galit ko sa kanila. Pero look at 18. But to the king of Judah which sent you to inquire of the Lord, thus shall ye say to him, thus saith the Lord God of Israel, as touching the words which thou hast heard, because thine heart was tender, and thou hast humbled thyself before the Lord, when thou heardest what I spake against this place, and against the inhabitants thereof, that they should become a desolation and a curse, and hast rent thy clothes and wept before me, I also have heard thee, saith the Lord. See, ang Diyos, may mga packets of grace. Hindi nawawala yung packets of grace ng Diyos. Pwedeng pinarurusahan lahat, papayungan ka niya. Pwedeng umuulan, nababasa ang lahat, pero nakapayong ka sa biyaya ng Diyos. Na habang lahat nababasa, ikaw hindi ka nababasa. Tuloy. Behold, therefore, I will gather thee unto the fathers, and thou shalt be gathered into thy grave in peace, and thine eyes shall not see all the evil which I will bring upon this place. And they brought the king word again. Siguro nakikita nyo, bakit bata siyang namatay? Sabi kasi ng Diyos, hindi ko na ipakikita sa iyo kung gaano katindi ang gagawin ko sa mga taong ito. sometimes death is God's grace. Halimbawa, yung pastor ko, iniisip ko noon, bakit agad namatay? Sabi ko, bakit? Napakabait na tao, napaka-spiritual na tao, napaka-honest na tao. Halos wala kang maipipintas sa kanya. Napakabuti sa paglilingkod sa Diyos. Napakabatang namatay. Alam niyo kung bakit? Kasi karamihan sa anak niya mapapariwara, sabi ng Diyos, ayoko nang makita mo yon. Ayoko na. Kukunin na kita. Dito ka na lang sa langit. Hindi ko ipakikita sa iyo yung sakit na mangyayari sa kanila. The same thing with Josiah. Sabi ng Diyos, hindi ko papakita sa iyo kung ano ang gagawin ko sa bayan mo. Kung ano ang gagawin ko sa Jerusalem at doon sa Judah. Pakituloy, anak. And the king sent and they gathered unto him all the elders of Judah and Jerusalem. So, hanggang doon muna tayo. So, we can see that in the midst of revival, of reformation, there was a chastisement. God showed Josiah what he's going to do, and it breaks the heart of Josiah. Sometimes, in the middle of the blessings that God is giving us, God all of a sudden will interject a chastisement in order to make us realize that it is all of God, not of us. Because sometimes when blessing comes, our ego is being pumped or puffed up. And like what happened to one king, I forgot his name, when he was able to get victory after victory, he said, I am great and God must put him down. So sometimes in the middle of blessing, God will send chastisement, and we must appreciate because that is God's reminder that everything is because of Him, not because of us. Amen? Do you remember the Apostle Paul? Among all the apostles, the greatest number of revelation was given to Paul. Remember that? But you know what the Bible says? Paul was given a thorn in the flesh because of the many revelations that was given to him. Why? So that he will keep his feet on the ground and he is not going to be puffed up. That is why these things are happening in our lives, because God is constantly reminding us that everything is because of Him, not because of us. Amen? Okay, malapit na. 2 Kings 23 verses 2 to 24. Basahin nyo na lang sa bahay, ha? Pwede na yan o basahin pa natin ngayon? Sa bahay na lang, ha? Okay. Bigyan ko na lang pinaka-summary. Okay. So, the book was read to Josiah. And what happened? He learned about the will of God. So now, listen. Now, it is not only what Josiah think that is into play. It is now what God saith that is now coming into play. So, if the Word of God is revealed and a light was given to us, listen, the only thing that we must do is act upon it. So we can see that when new revelations and new light and new understanding came into Josiah, he immediately changes course and he determined to bring that same virtue to the area that had been previously lacking. So, yung mga hindi niya pa nagagawa, kasi hindi niya alam kung tama o mali, dahil wala siyang word of God, hindi niya pinakialaman. Ngayon, nalaman niya kung ano yung tama at mali. Lahat na nakita niyang mali, inayos niya. At lahat ng tama, pinatindi niya. So, this is the purpose of the Word of God. As we learn, we change according to the knowledge and wisdom from God's Word. That's why change is not bad. Some people will say, how can I trust you? This is what you taught before. Now you change it. And you change it again. Revelation is progressive. As you learn more, as you understand more, there will be changes because you will go according to the light and understanding of the Word of God. Dati, ito paniniwala natin. Ba't natin nabago? Kasi pinakita ng Diyos, ito yung buong kalooban niya. So, revelation is always progressive. Walang naligtas, alam niya na lahat. Tama, mali? Walang naligtas, alam niya agad kung ano yung dapat niyang iwasan at hindi. As he learned the Word of God,
progressively there will be changes.
Amen. Progressively there will be what you call change of decision and action in life. As you grow in the grace, you also grow and mature in your actions. Because you cannot do what you do not know. But once you knew it, then you have to do it.
Kaya we thank God when we are being reproved.
We thank God when we are being rebuked. Because we are learning and we are changing. And this is what happened to Josiah. So he did that which was right in the sight of the Lord, and he changed those things according to the word of God. Why? Look at Proverbs 4:18. But the path of the just is as the shining light that shineth more and more unto the perfect day. So, nag-shine, maliwanag, at lalong nagliliwanag, at paliwanag ng paliwanag hanggang sa perfect na kaliwanagan. Ay, di ba? Ano sabi ng 1 Corinthians chapter 13? From a child, we speak as a child. Di ba? But now, face to face. Oh, may pagbabago. Kaya, ganun din tayo. Mga kapatid, pag natututunan natin, ginagawa natin. Huwag sabihin, Pastor, dati tahimik lang tayong simbahan. Ngayon, nakikipaglaban na tayo. Eh, natutunan natin na yun ang pinagagawa ng Diyos eh. Ano gagawin natin? Sabi ng Diyos, contend for the faith. No, God, we know better than you. Hindi pwede. Ay, hindi ba? Nakita natin na mali pala yung turo na first fruits. Ay, ayaan na lang natin. No, sabihin natin, mali yan. Kung makinig sila, good. Kung di sila makinig, bahala sila. But we do our job. Amen? In proclaiming the truth. Ganun yun. Kaya pag may nabasa ka sa Facebook na mali, alam mo yung tama, i-post mo yung tama. Pastor, bang sabihin, kontrabida ako? Hindi, bida ka sila kontra. Amen? Why? Because what we're telling them is right. You see, being silent in the midst of wrong is siding with the wrong. Ba, nagsalita ka rin, ano? Ganon. Nagsaside tayo doon. Sa mali, nabasa mo, nakalagay doon, Jesus is a failure. Oh, nakapost. May nagpost. Jesus is a failure. Nabasa mo, nang gagawin mo? Like, kahit man lang yung cry, yung sad ba yan? Sad. Tapos mag-ano ka? Magbigay ka ng verse. Oh, yung perfect siya. Yung almighty siya, paano magiging failure? Oh, hindi ba? So, ipakita mo yon. Hindi, nabasa mo, nag-Facebook ka pa, wala nang palang kabuluhan. Oh. Sabi ron, ang mga Baptist, mga demonyo, sagot ka, hindi lahat, kamo, oh. Di ba? Hindi lahat, kamo. Oh, ganun, at least, nakasagot ka, nasabi mo yung totoo, na hindi lahat. Kung madadagdagan mo pa, may Bible base, mas maganda. Because we should act according to the light that is given us. Do not be afraid of the light. It is the thing that we need in order to really appreciate the goodness of God in our lives. Huwag tayong matakot sa light. Ay, buti pang di ko na nalaman to. Naku. Bakit buti pang hindi mo nalaman yung totoo? Buti nga nalaman mo yung totoo. Amen? Na sa ganun maibahagi natin kung ano yung totoo. If there is a hope that we are really God's, then as we receive more light from Him, then we are going to obey Him with all of our hearts. And last part po dito sa 2 Chronicles 35:1-19. Huwag nyo nang basahin ngayon, i-note nyo. Basahin nyo sa bahay. Pero may kinalaman to sa binasa natin kanina. So after all of these things, nireinstitute ni Josiah, pakinggan nyo to, ang Passover. Ang Passover, ito po ang foreshadow ng crucifixion ng Panginoon. You see, even though Judah is already doomed because he will be judged by God because of all his sins, The reason why Josiah instituted the Passover is because he believed that even though Judah as a nation is doomed, individually they can be saved by trusting the Lord Jesus Christ. Mga kapatid, pakinggan niyo mabuti, importante ito. Ang mundo doomed. The Bible says it will become worse and worse. Sabi ng Bible, it will be consumed by fire. No matter what people does, climate change, etc., etc., eat the children. Biro mo naman yung tao ngayon. Grabe. In order to save the earth, eat the children. Ewan ko kung kahapon lang o makalawa lang inapprove na sa Canada, legal na ang pakikipag-sex sa hayop. Ano gagawin mo sa mundo? The world is doomed. Wala na. Kahit ano pa mangyari, it will be consumed by fire. It will be destroyed. It will be judged by God. Pero, individuals can be saved by the preaching of God's word. Kaya hindi tayo sa social gospel eh. Hindi tayo sa social ano, reform. Sa ano tayo? Spiritual reform. Doon tayo. Kasi, even though this world is doomed, there is still hope for every individual. And that is the same thing in Josiah. The prophetess already told Josiah, it's too late. This country will be destroyed by God. Don't worry, you will die before God will do that. But Josiah said in his heart, I will institute the Passover again so that individuals of my country can still believe on the Lord Jesus Christ as the Passover shows His sacrificial death on the cross in due time. Nakuha niyo? That is why this is the most important act that Josiah did during his reign. And ano sabi ng Bible? Balik nga tayo sa text natin bago tayo magwakas kanina dito sa 2 Kings chapter 24 and 25. Moreover, 25. And like unto him was there no king before him. You see, he's one of a kind. Pagkatapos niya, wala nang naging haring katulad niya. And like unto him was there no king before him that turned to the Lord with all his heart. Siya na yung huli. The last good king of Israel. Siya na yung huli. And with all his soul and with all his might, according to all the law of Moses, neither after him arose there any like him. Walang siya naging katulad. 26. Notwithstanding, the Lord turned not from the fierceness of his great wrath, wherewith his anger was kindled against Judah because of the provocations that Manasseh had provoked him withal. 27. And the Lord said, I will remove Judah, etc., etc. And let us go to 2 Chronicles 35:1-19. Sa abahin nyo na lang basahin ulit para hindi na natin ulitin pa. You will see here Hebrews 11:28. I-connect na lang natin bago tayo magwakas. Through faith he kept the Passover and the sprinkling of blood, lest he that destroyed the firstborn should touch them. By faith, during his time, Josiah reinstituted the Passover, believing that this is God's way of saving his people. At pag binasa niyo yung 35:1-19, may description. Wala pang Passover na naging katulad nung ginawa niyang Passover. Meaning to say, yung meaning, buong-buo. Kasi, ilang taon, halos 100 taong walang Passover. Isipin niyo. It was commanded by God to Israel. And for almost 100 years, there was no Passover in Israel. It was reinstituted by Josiah. So as we end, let us look at several things that we need to consider as a way of summary. Josiah was faithful in an evil environment. Amen. We should be like that also, because we are living in an evil world. The god of this world is Satan, and we are pilgrims and strangers in this world. His righteousness did not come from the influence of his family. His righteousness did not come from the influence of society, but he allowed those people, godly people, to influence him and the word of God to shape his life. Josiah demonstrated his faithfulness as he instituted changes in Israel. Ladies and gentlemen, let us not be afraid of change if change is for the good. He acted wonderfully to the law of the Lord. Once he understood the word of God, straight away, he obeyed God's word. Josiah gave us a great example to follow. Ano yun? That we are going to have a tender heart in accepting the word of God and doing it. Not only hearers, but doers of the word. We must be filled with godly sorrow if sin is happening in our lives and even in the lives of other people, because sin is something that we should not be happy about. He sought to know as much of the will of God as he could. Until we have time, let us open the pages of the book of the Bible. Let us read. Let us study diligently. Let us rightly divide the word of truth, because as we know the word of God, more light will come in. And when more light will come in, more light will shine out of our lives. He walked in the way of God, not turning aside. When we obey God, the Bible says, if you will put your hands to the plow, don't look back. You just continue and finish what God wanted you to do. And then, knowing the value of the law, he shared it with others. He asked Shaphan and the scribes to read the book to all the people so that the people will know. And as a church, don't allow that only the pastors and the preachers know the Bible. Every member must know the Bible. Every member must understand the Bible. Every member must become a skillful handler of the Word of God. Because when these things happen, then we will be able to serve God and glorify God in our lives. Amen? So, in short, that is the life of King Josiah. I hope and I pray that in our lives, most of these things that we saw in Josiah will also be seen in each and every one of us. Amen? Shall we stand up? Let us pray.